Parents, kids, gather as we begin our lesson on You're Invited and what it looks like to worship. Maybe you're wondering why I have all of these rocks. I do have a rock collection at home from Israel, but these are not special rocks. They're just rocks. And I wonder if you think these rocks could sing. Think if I took out a permanent marker and I drew faces on them that these rocks would be able to talk. I wonder if maybe they could tell stories of Jesus. If these rocks could cry out, I wonder if they would what they would say. Maybe this rock would share the story of a shepherd boy named David and how he used a small stone to slay a giant to show that God can do anything when God is with us. Or maybe this rock might tell us of the prophet Elijah and how he used stones to build an altar to God. And the altar was used to sacrifice to God to prove he is the one true God. Or maybe this rock might tell us of Solomon and how he used stones to build a beautiful temple for people to worship God. And yet still there's other rocks that might remind us of stories that Jesus once told, of the wise man who built his house upon the rock, that when the storm came, the house on the rock stood firm. When we look at rocks, may they remind us that we can praise God because he has been so good to us. These rocks have stories to tell us, but they won't. We won't let them. As followers of Jesus, in our story today, we're going to take a look at what it means to praise our King. And as long as we praise the King, there will be no need for the stones to cry out. So in today's story, we're going to look at what it means for the stones and the rocks to cry out from Luke chapter 19, verses 27 through 30. But before we do that, let's pray. So, dear Lord, we know that you would rather hear us praise you than to hear a rock concert, to hear these rocks cry out. So, God, we lift your name on high today in the midst of wherever we are. God, we give you praise and we cry out for what you're doing. Amen. The theme of this week is we can worship God out loud. And so there's a lesson for you as parents to try and to use at home. We always begin at church with a time of worship. So if you want to find the YouTube channel with the Palm Sunday songs on them, there's a link for you to find the songs. If there's a beginning welcome time, if you want to find a coloring page or you want to find a piece of paper and have the kids draw what they're thinking, there's some questions to ask them about what it means for them to worship. What's their favorite worship song? How do they worship? And encourage you as parents to think about it and share with them too. And then there's the Bible story, and it's in red, where you can read it to your kids. And share the story. And then it has some questions that follow to dig in a little bit. And following those questions, there's more specific questions, and there's some for younger kid discussion and some for older kid discussion, depending what age group you have. There's a memory verse to focus as a family, and there's actions to go with each of the sections of the memory verse to be able to help ingrain it, not only in our minds, but with our bodies as well. And then there's some activities to do. The party games is a loud one. If you have balloons, warning if you don't want loud. And then there's another one called Alphabet Praise, where you sit in a circle and you go around and use each of the letters of the alphabet to say something that you're grateful for to God. And then there's a time of prayer. a time where we're going to tell God how amazing He is. And there's some suggestions for you on how to pray this week. The action prayer is using a bowl of water and putting our hands in the bowl of water to remind us about how God washes away and forgives our sins and how amazing that is. And then there's a few extra things for you to do if you have time throughout the week. You can make some musical instruments, and they give some suggestions on how to do that with your kids. And then it also has some digging deeper. When you can't help but praise God, it gives you some reflection, some acting out, some drawing things to do with your kids. And then also there's some songs you can sing to just have your kids be able to dance or just be able to worship and praise God. And so we will be sending a PDF of this home so that you can do the lesson at home with your kids sometime this week. We acknowledge that this is just a different time. I would love to be able to gather together tomorrow night with the kids and be able to do this in person, but we can't. And so we're just trying to navigate this the best we can. And so in this season, maybe you're longing for rhythm like I am, and 6:30 to 7:30 on Wednesday night, you want to sit down with your family and talk about this. Or maybe you need to do it at lunchtime someday this week. But we just want you to know that as a church body, that we love you, we care about you as families. We miss seeing your faces, but I just encourage you to be able to gather together around the table, around the TV, to be able to connect not only with each other as a family, but also connect with God. And soon we will be together again. And so just know we love you, we miss you, and we are praying for you in this time of social distancing. Blessings.